Hi everyone. So in today's video we'll discuss about sex determination. So what is a sex determination? So in simple terms we can call determination of the sex is called sex determination, or establishment of the male and female individuals is called as sex determination. So in the animals, so there are three modes of the sex determination by which we can determine the sex of an individual. So the first mode is, or the first method is environmental method. Second one is the non-allosomal method or non-chromosomal method. And the third one is called as allosomal method or chromosomal method of sex determination. So let us discuss one by one in detail. So first one is environmental method of sex determination. So in the first one we have again two types, where the environment decides, okay, whether the individual will be male or female. So in the first one it is the association with the family. So the newly born individual, which is generally sex unspecified, or if it is sexually undifferentiated, then association of that individual with the family will decide whether it will be becoming a male or a female. And the second one is the incubation temperature. So that also decides whether the egg will be going to form as a male or a female individual. Now, the first one is association of or with the family. So here we have an example that is called as Bonellia. Bonellia basically belongs to an annelid. And this female Bonellia, once she gives or hatches out, once she lays the eggs, once the egg will hatch into the larvae, so that larvae is sexually undifferentiated. Now this sexually undifferentiated larvae, whether it will become a male or a female, so that will be decided by the female. Now the female Bonellia will produce a chemical that is called as Bonellin. Okay, and this Bonellin, so the newly hatched larvae, which is sexually undifferentiated, so if that larvae comes in contact with that of this chemical Bonellin secreted by the female Bonellia, then that larvae will get converted into male. Okay, and this male becomes a parasite and it lives in the uterus of the female body. So that is when the larvae, which is sexually undifferentiated, when it comes in contact with that of the female or the Bonellin, then it becomes into male. If that sexually undifferentiated larvae, if it remains far away from the female Bonellia, so that will not come in contact with the chemical Bonellin, and thereby it results in the formation of the female. And remember, this larvae which is being formed, which is free from, or which is never it comes in contact with that of the Bonellin, so now that becomes a free living. As I said, if the larvae comes in contact with Bonellin, then it becomes male and it becomes a parasite and lives in the uterus of the female Bonellia. If the larvae does not come in contact with that of the Bonellin, then it becomes a female and it is a free living individual. So that is the example where the environment will decide, that is a chemical will decide whether that individual, the larvae which is sexually undifferentiated, will become male or female. Now the second method, in that of the environmental method of sex determination, that is incubation temperature. So incubation temperature, so here what the temperature is necessary for the incubation, so that temperature will decide whether the eggs will hatch out into a male individual or a female individual. So here I have quoted two examples. One is of the turtle, second one is of the alligator, third is a crocodile, and the fourth one is a skink. Okay, now in the turtles, if the temperature is less than 28 degrees during incubation, then this will result in the formation of the male individuals. If it is more than 33 degrees centigrade, then that results in the formation of the female individuals. I am speaking about the turtles. If the temperature is lesser than 28 degrees during the incubation time, then it will result in the male. And if the temperature is more than 33 degrees centigrade, then the egg will be formed into the female. Now, there is a question. What happens if the temperature is in between 28 and 33 degrees? If it is there in between 28 to 33 degrees centigrade, then that results into equal number of the males as well as females. So that is in the turtles. Now, in the alligator, okay, or in that of the crocodiles, or in that of the skink, if the temperature is lesser than that of the 30 degrees centigrade, then the young one will become female. And if the temperature is more than around 34 degrees centigrade, then that will result in the formation of the male. So this is in the alligators and in that of the crocodiles and skinks. So if the temperature is less than 30 degrees centigrade during the incubation time of the egg, then it results in the formation of the female. And if the temperature is more than 34 degrees centigrade during the incubation, then that results in the formation of the males. Okay, so this is where the temperature is influencing, okay, the determination of the sex. So these are the two modes of the environmental method of the sex determination. Now we have the second one, that is non-allosomal method or non-chromosomal method. So in the non-allosomal or chromosomal method, so this is being commonly seen in that of the bacteria. In the bacteria, there is presence of a sex determining factor. So this sex determining factor is located on the autosome. Where we can even call this sex determining factor as a fertility factor. And if this fertility factor, if it is present in the bacteria, then it will become male. If the fertility factor, if it is absent, then it will become the female. So here, the sex determining factor or the fertility factor which is present on the autosomes or on the F plasmid, if that is present, then male. If it is absent, then it becomes female. So that is a non-allosomal, or which means there are no involvement of the sex chromosomes, but autosomes are involved. Okay, where these autosomes will have the fertility factor or sex determining factor. So that is how the male and females will be formed in that of the bacteria. So that is another mode of sex determination which is commonly seen in the bacteria. Next is the very important for the NEET or any competitive exam is the allosomal method or chromosomal method of the sex determination. So in this we have five different types. The first one is XXXY type of the sex determination, which is commonly seen in Drosophila and human beings. XXXO type, which is seen in the grasshoppers and cockroaches. ZZZW, which is commonly seen in the birds or apes. And the fourth one is ZZZO type, which is seen in the butterflies and moths. And the last one we have is the haplodiploidy type, which is a unique type of the sex determination, which is seen in the honeybees, wasp, ants, and etc. So let's get into the detail of the allosomal method of sex determination, where we'll discuss one by one. So let us have the first one, where we have the XX, XY type of the sex determination. Now, the allosomes are also commonly called as sex chromosomes, or they are called as ediochromosomes. And here, in that of the sex chromosomes, so the females have X and X sex chromosome, whereas the males will have X and Y sex chromosomes. Now, in the males, in the females, both the chromosomes which are present, they are similar. So thereby we call them as the chromosomes which are present in the female. So they are called as homomorphic, because both are same. And these homomorphic chromosomes always produce homogametes. They will produce homogametes, means similar type of the gametes. Whereas in the males, there are presence of the two sex chromosomes, where one is X, the other one is Y. So here, these together we call them as heteromorphic chromosomes. Heteromorphic chromosome. And these heteromorphic chromosomes always produce two different types of gametes. So thereby we call these gametes as heterogametes. Okay. And now, here, the females, as they have the same type of the sex chromosomes, where we call them as homomorphic, okay? So, this is what we call female homogamety, because both are the similar type of sex chromosomes. Whereas in the males, as they differ, as both the chromosomes differ from each other, we call them as heteromorphic. And this is what we call as male heterogamety, because males are having or producing two different types of gametes, where the sperm will have, one sperm will have normal autosomes, that is 22 in human beings, and along with that it will have the X chromosome, and in another set of the sperms there will be presence of 22 pairs of autosomes, 22 autosomes and one Y chromosome. So as the two types of gametes are being produced, we call it as male heterogamety. Now, one brief information is all about that the discovery of the X chromosome. So X chromosome was being discovered by Henking in the year 1891, and the Y chromosome was being discovered in the year 1902. By Stevens. Okay, so Stevens discovered Y chromosome. So when we compare the size of the X to that of Y, Y is said to be very small in its size when compared to that of X chromosome. So that was discovered by Stevens. Now, the sperm which carries X chromosome in it, it is called as a gynosperm or gynosome, and the sperm which carries Y chromosome is called as androsperm or androsome. Now, it is truly believed that in the XXXY type of sex determination, it is that the males will decide whether the offspring which will be born, the progeny which will be formed, so that will be, that sex will be determined by the male itself, not by the female. Because I will show you here, so in the female, the gamete which is produced, so that will be ovum. So ova will have the normal set of the autosomes, that is, I am talking about human beings, where it is having around 22 autosomes are there. Along with that, it will have the X chromosome. Okay, so this will be the ova, which will have 22 autosomes plus X chromosome, and another ova will be again 22 autosomes with the X chromosome. Whereas in the human males, so human males will produce the sperm where it will carry 22 autosomes plus the X chromosome. So this will be one of the sperm which will have X chromosome and 22 autosomes plus Y chromosome. So this will be the 50% of the chromosomes. So in the human males produce 50% of the sperms which will have X chromosome and 50% of the sperms will have Y chromosome. Now, during the process of fertilization, by chance, if the sperm having X chromosome, if it fuses with that of the ova having X chromosome, the resulting offspring will have 44 autosomes plus X and X chromosome. So the zygote contains 2 X chromosome, which means that the offspring which will be born will be female. So here the sperm is going to decide whether the newborn individual will be male or female. And if the sperm having Y chromosome, if it fuses with that of the egg having X chromosome, so here 44 autosomes plus X and Y. So the zygote will have X and Y sex chromosomes, thereby the resulting individual will be male. So the male will decide whether the newly born individual will be male or female. So as there is involvement of the sex chromosome here, we call it as the allosomal method, and where we are using the XX and XY type of the sex chromosome. So this is called as XX and XY type of sex determination, which is commonly seen in that of the Drosophila as well as human beings. See, in the Drosophila, so Drosophila have 4 pair of the chromosomes, of which 3 pair are autosomes and 1 pair are the sex chromosomes. In human beings have 22 pairs of autosomes and 1 pair of the sex chromosome. So, either it may be the Drosophila or the human beings, it is the sex chromosome which is being present, where the ova will have always the X type of the sex chromosome, whereas the male will have 2 different types of the sperms, where one sperm will have X chromosome and the other sperm will have the Y chromosome. So this is the first method that is commonly seen in the Drosophila and human beings, that is XX, XY type of the sex determination. So now is the second one. Second one on in that of the allosomal method of sex determination. So second one is XX, XO type of the sex determination, which is being commonly seen in the grasshoppers as well as the cockroaches. So here also the females. So females are homogametic and the males are heterogametic. So here also the females are able to produce the ova, where I will write A for autosome and X for that of the sex chromosome. And this is the ova which is being produced by the female. And the XO type. Now here the females are homogametic while the males are heterogametic. So males are able to produce 2 types of gamete, where one will have the sperm which carries the X chromosome and other sperm will not have any sex chromosome. Now you may have a doubt in your mind, if a gamete has only autosome, whether it is being regarded as a normal gamete or an abnormal gamete. So this particular question has an answer, that in the grasshoppers and cockroaches, if a gamete has only the autosome, then that gamete is said to be normal. But in the human beings, if the gamete does not contain the sex chromosome, then it results into an abnormal individual. Now, Here, the males are able to produce two type of the sperms where 50% of the sperms will have X chromosome and 50% of the sperms will not have the sex chromosome. Now, where this sex chromosome has been lost? So, this sex chromosome has been lost in the process of the meiosis 2, where there is a non-disjunction of the chromosome. So, during this non-disjunction of the chromosome, so there is a loss of the sex chromosome in that of the males. So, here, if the sperm which has that of the X chromosome, if it fuses with that of the ova having an X chromosome, the resulting zygote or the offspring will have two X chromosome, which means it will result in the formation of the female. And if the sperm which does not contain sex chromosome, that is why we are showing here it as zero. Okay, so if this sperm which does not have the sex chromosome, if it fuses with that of the ova having a normal X chromosome, here the offspring will result in the formation of the male. Okay, so this is said to be the normal chromosomal complement. Although there is an absence of one sex chromosome, these individuals are said to be healthy and fertile males. But if it is there in that of the human beings, where if one of the sex chromosome, if it is being lost, then we call it as a Turner's syndrome. Okay, so that is in that of the human beings. But in cockroaches and grasshopper, it is normal chromosomal complement. So this is the second mode of the sex determination, called as XX XO method, where the females are homogametic, which produce the same type of gametes, which always have X chromosome, and males will produce two different type of gametes, where 50% of the sperms will have X chromosome and 50% do not have any sex chromosome. Okay, so that is second one. So next is the third type of the sex chromosome, sex determination. So that is ZZ, ZW type, which is commonly seen in the birds or the apes. So very interesting is that in the birds, see, in the first example of the sex determination, which is seen in the Drosophila and in the human beings, we said that the female is homogametic while males are heterogametic. So that is true with that of the grasshoppers as well as cockroaches. So here also females are homogametic and males are heterogametic. But in case of the birds, birds will have the males as heterogametic. So in the earlier method of sex determination, male were being responsible for determining the sex of the young one, whereas in the birds, it is that the female will decide whether the egg will become a male or a female. So here in the birds, the males are homogametic and the female are heterogametic, which means females are able to produce two different types of the ova, and meanwhile the males will produce the gametes that will be the similar type. So males are able to produce A plus Z, so that is a sperm, and A plus Z, so both the sperms will have the same chromosomes, whereas the female will produce two different types of the ova, where 50% of the ova will have A plus Z chromosome and 50% of the ova will have A plus W. So two different types of ova. So thereby we are calling females as heterogametic, because two different types of gametes are produced. Now, if the sperm having Z chromosome, if it fuses with that of, the ova having Z chromosome, so the resulting offspring will become male. Okay, and if the sperm having Z chromosome, I am talking about sex chromosome. If that fuses with that of the ova having W, that is another sex chromosome in the ova, then the resulting offspring will become, okay, that will be AA and ZW. So this results in the formation of the female. So here in the birds, females will decide whether the offspring will become male or female. So that is seen in birds. Now next one, the fourth type is the ZO type of the sex determination, which is commonly seen in the butterflies and moths. Butterfly and moth. Now in this also, males are homogametic, while females are heterogametic, which means that males will produce the same type of the sperms, that is A plus Z and A plus Z. So both the sperms, all the sperms will have the same chromosomes, that is A plus Z. Meanwhile, the females will produce the ova, where 50% of the ova will have the Z and 50% of the ova will not have any sex chromosome, which is very similar to that of the grasshoppers and the cockroaches. But here the males are heterogametic, but in butterflies and moths, females are heterogametic. So that sex chromosome is being lost during the meiosis. Now, if the sperm having Z chromosome, if it fuses with that of the ova having, okay, Z chromosome, then the resulting offspring will become what? Male. And if the sperm having Z chromosome, if it fuses with that of the ova having O chromosome, then that will result in the formation of the females. So in the four methods of the sex determination, in the allosomal method, what we have discussed is XX and XY, so that is first one, XX and XO, that is second one. So here in these two methods, the males will decide whether the offspring will be male or female, and in the third and the fourth, we have where the females will decide whether the offspring will be born, okay, that will be male or female. So here in birds, butterflies and moths, the females will decide, okay, about the sex of the offspring.